अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्ताम् वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम् श्रुतिस्मृति पुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्रीचिद्गणगणेशं सुखं नित्यं स्वप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपे अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिपूर्तिं बुद्धेर्दुःखेत्युनिर्मलम् अपारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महः तदेवाहं नमत्वन्यदिति मे निश्चितामतिः। ब्रह्मणजातिपुरवेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुम्हदेवम् आत्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुक्षुर्वै शरणं प्रपद्ये। शांति शांति। सो इन द फोर्थ चैप्टर शिष्य इज बीइंग आंसर्ड बाय द गुरु एज टू केस ऑफ ज्ञानी बीइंग डिफरेंट देन द अज्ञानी ओनली इन वन एस्पेक्ट विषय आनंद is not separate from Atmananda in both cases, but the jnani knows that it is the same Swarupananda, Atmananda, which is manifesting as Vishyananda, but he also has Vishyananda, just like the ajnani who doesn't know that the Vishyananda is Swarupananda and thereby craves for Vishyananda. Now, the Jagat not having Ananda, therefore Vishaya does not have Ananda was established. Now, if the Vishaya does not have Ananda, why is it that the Anubhava of Ananda in Vishaya continues to be? There is a Pratiti. For that, the Guru had said that Jagat itself is not there, let alone Ananda, Anubhava. The Jagat is not there, so the Jagat Nivritti cannot happen. Where Dukkha Nivritti, you are looking for Dukkha Nivritti. It started from Vishaya Ananda. If Vishaya does not have Ananda, if there is Swarup Ananda, then how can there be Dukkha? So for that the Guru had said, Dukkha is never in you. It is not there because Jagat itself is not there. But then Jagat Pratiti is there, Dukkha Pratiti is there. For that, the Shishya has questioned as to how is it that one which isn't there, ever there, Kalatrepiyan nasti, tasya pratiti katham bhavati. For that, the Guru had said that pratiti is there because it is the asat, kalatreya asat is paramarthika drishtya, vyavaharika drishtya, there is mithyatvam. The anubhava of dukkha or even vishaya sukha, in fact, the vishaya itself, prapancha itself is brahma, it is mithya. There is no prapancha, and non-existent prapancha that comes to anubhava is called as mithya prapancha. And the example given is Rajju Sarpa. In Rajju, the Sarpa is never there in any of the three periods of time, but still there is a pratiti of Sarpa. Now the example has to be understood, otherwise the exemplified cannot be known. So thereby, there is an analysis now as to, this is a little technical section because we see all matas as to how there is sarpa pratiti in Rajju. Rajjau sarpa pratiti katam iti prashnaha. How can there be sarpa brahma, appearance of sarpa in Rajju? We should not say brahma because brahma is not accepted by everyone. So sarpa pratiti, the appearance of sarpa in Rajju is there. That is accepted by everyone because there is an anubhava. Now this sarpa, whether it is there in Rajju or not, in fact it is seen in the place of Rajju, but Rajju really alone is there. Only Rajju is there. So how is there a sarpa pratiti when there is only Rajju in front of you? That is the question. That being understood, one can analyze as to how Jagat can appear in Brahmatma, where it is not there in any of the three periods of time. रज्जौ प्रतीयमान सर्पादयः यथा मिथ्या तथैव प्रत्यगात्मनि प्रतीयमान संसार दुःखम् अपि मिथ्या इति यदुक्तम्। व्हाट वाज सेड एज जस्ट लाइक इन द एग्जांपल वेयर देयर इज अ प्रतीति ऑफ सर्प भूछिद्र इत्यादि इन रज्जु इन द रोप, सिमिलरली देयर इज एन एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ संसार दुःख, संसार एंड दुःख, संसार रूप दुख ऑल्सो इन प्रत्यगात्मा ब्रह्म एंड दैट इज सिमिलरली मिथ्या, दैट अनुभव इज ऑल्सो इक्वली मिथ्या इति यदुक्तम्, विच वॉज स्टेटेड अर्लियर तत्र विद रिस्पेक्ट टू दैट। दृष्टांत ज्ञानमंतरा दार्ष्टान्तिक ज्ञाना संभवाद् रज्जौ सर्प कथमो भासत इति प्रथमतः तावन् मां बोधयन्तु भवन्तः इति शिष्यः दृष्टांत विषये पृच्छति। He inquires into the drishtanta because having known the drishtanta clearly, darshtantika siddhi can take place. Because drishtanta jnanamantara, unless you understand the drishtanta, drishtanta should be, which should be known to the other, it should be acceptable to the other, then only darshtantika, the exemplified, will make sense. So he inquires into the drishtanta itself, how is there a sarpa bhranti, sarpa pratiti in Rajju, kathama obhasate iti prathamata. First of all itself he asks the question and says, bhavanta mam bodhayantu, please the guru should teach me how that example works, then I'll understand the exemplified. Shishyah swaprashnasya ashayam varnayati, and he is well qualified, the shishya himself is well qualified. He has studied. So there is a background given through the Shishya as to what are the different types of, you know, with the Shishya's question, there is Khyati Chatushtayam talked about. There are four Khyatis which are famous. Khyati is basically the derivative meaning. Yogikartha of Khyati is Jnanam. And this Jnanam in this case is not Prama. It is Brahma. Brahma Jnanam. So jnana can be a valid knowledge or it can be invalid knowledge. In this case, the khyati usage, rudhi artha of khyati in philosophical granthas, in the shastra, is brahma. How is the possibility of brahma? What we are seeing in the example, the sarpa, how is the sarpa khyati? How does sarpa take sarpa pratiti take place? That explanation regarding that is explained through khyati, khyati vada. And those are four generally. There are more which have come up later as well, but then generally broadly they are four. Khyati chatushtayam. What are these? Rajju sarpa shukti rajatadi brahma vishaye mata chatushtayam shruyate. So four khyatis are well known. In the case of Brahma, what kind of Brahma? The Rajju Sarpa or Shukti Rajata. Rajju Sarpa and Shukti Rajata are generally given to show one, for one reason, it is because there are two examples, two are better than one. But then Rajju Sarpa shows Nivritti, one runs away from Sarpa. So in the case of Jagat, there is Nivritti from Jagat, Dvesha towards Sarpa. So using that example, Dvesha towards Jagat is established. And Shukti Rajata shows Raga. There is Pravritti towards Rajata. That is also Bhranti. And using that example, Pravritti towards Raga towards Jagat, Jagat Vishaya is established. So Rajju Sarpa. Sarpa and Shukti Rajata Adi Padena, everything that one is neutral towards, the entire prapancha, whether you like it or don't like it, that's how it is. But this entire prapancha is Brahma. Using the examples of Rajju Sarpa and Shukti Rajata, it is established. And in this case of Brahma, what exactly is happening? That is well known in four ways, understood in four ways. What are the possibilities? So various philosophers, various darshanas talk about different types of khyatis. They explain this Rajju Sarpa differently and then they extend it to the prapancha also. This is how the prapancha is. But then how is Rajju Sarpa? In that case itself, there is a difference of opinion. So we cannot just assume that just because prapancha is like Rajju Sarpa, everyone agrees that it is Rajju Sarpa. Just because everyone agrees that it is like Rajju Sarpa, they also agree the way Rajju Sarpa Pratiti takes place. Even if they agree, I'm not saying that everyone agrees that prapancha is like Rajju Sarpa, but even if they agree that it is like Rajju Sarpa, then actually it is an Upanishad statement. Outside the Dasha Upanishad, there are many Upanishads. They talk about prapancha srishti like Rajju Sarpa. So it's a shruti. That's why shruyate. Mata chatushtayam shruyate. So they cannot really disagree. If they disagree, they do not know that such an Upanishad statement does exist, or they do not agree that it is an Upanishad at all. That is an aside. But those who say that Rajju Sarpa Vat Prapanchaha, there also the agreement with Rajju Sarpa Pratiti being in a particular manner is not, I mean, there is no agreement with Rajju Sarpa Pratiti being in a particular manner. There are four ways that is understood. Tatra Shunyavadi Asat Khyati Maha. There is Asat Khyati as per Shunyavadi Buddhist. Bauddhas say, in Bauddhas they have Kshanika Vada also. Kshanika Vijnana Vadi, he is also Bauddha. Atma Khyati Machashte. He explains it through Atma Khyati. We'll see what these are. Asat Khyati, Atma Khyati, these are two Khyati Vadas of Bauddhas. Nayayikaha Vaisheshikascha. The logicians both put together, Nyaya Darshana and Vaisheshika Darshana, both are logicians. Nayayika Vaisheshikascha Anyatha Khyati Atishtanti. Anyatha Khyati. They say this Rajju Sarpa, Sarpa in Rajju is due to Anyatha Khyati. Sankhyaha Prabhakarascha. Sankhyas, Sankhya Darshana, Yoga being there, you know, the practice of Sankhya. Sankhyas and Prabhakara. Prabhakara, Prabhakara. Prabhakara is Purva Mimamsaka. So Prabhakara, there is a Bhattamata and there is a Prabhakara Mata Purva Mimamsakas also. I think Prabhakara was a Shishya of Kumarla Bhatta. So Kumarla Bhatta has an explanation for this, and Prabhakara disagrees with it and he gives something else. So Sankhyaha Prabhakarascha Akhyatim Vadanti. They talk about this Sarpa in Rajju as Akhyati. We'll see what these are. These are looked at into detail. Asat Khyati first. So Asat Khyati, Atma Khyati, Anyatha Khyati and Akhyati. These are the Khyati Chatushtayam. Asat Khyati. What is Asat Khyati? This is for Shunyavadis. Asat. Khyati is Asat. It is Asat. Sarpa is Asat. The Sarpa in Rajju is non-existent, completely non-existent. Not only completely non-existent, they say Sarpa anywhere is non-existent. Not only Sarpa, Rajju is also non-existent. Thereby, Prapancha itself is non-existent. Everything in your example as well as exemplified is non-existent. They will say even the Atma is non-existent, and that is their Asat Khyati. What is non-existent appears to be. Tatra Asat Khyatim Angi Kuruvatam Shunyavadinam Evam Ashaya. What do they say? Rajjau Tavat Sarpaha Atyantam Asan. It is completely non-existent. That Sarpa in Rajju is completely non-existent. Tatha Eva Anyatrapi. And this Sarpa which you see in Rajju, not only that Sarpa is non-existent, but Sarpa itself is non-existent. There is no Sarpa at all. Let alone the Bhranti of Sarpa that takes place there, and you are thinking whether or not there is Sarpa in Rajju. They say Sarpa, there is nothing called as Sarpa. Tatha Eva Anyatrapi Valmikadav Api. So Valmikadav, where Sarpa stays, you know, the Sarpa Bila. Sarpa Bila, there also, Sarpa Atyantam Asanneva. It is not there at all. There is nothing called Sarpa. So don't look for Sarpa in Rajju. There is no Sarpa anywhere. But it appears. एवं अत्यंत असत सर्पस्य प्रतीति प्रतीति रज्जौ. सो प्रतीति देयर इज अ संधि हियर. प्रतीति ही रज्जौ ढलोपे पूर्वस्य दीर्घवर्णः. सो रोरी रेफा फॉलोड बाय रेफा देयर इज रेफलोप. प्रतीतिर देयर इज प्रतीतिर हियर दैट रेफा अंडरगोज लोप एंड देन देयर इज अनदर सूत्र ढलोपे पूर्वस्य दीर्घवर्णः. So this and which is preceding and is pratyahara maheshwar sutra antargata pratyah pratyahara this that pratyahara has ikara that ikara will take dirgha. So this is not pratiti shabda pratitihi. So sarpasya pratitihi rajyau. When you do a sandhi it will be sarpasya pratiti rajyau bhavati. Evam atyanta asata sarpasya, that's sarpa which is asan, non-existent, completely non-existent, it still appears. Evam, it although non-existent, there is still a pratiti. If you ask in Rajju, how can there be pratiti if it is atyanta asat, he will tell you that, do you see sarpa elsewhere? Yeah, he'll say there also it is not there, but you see. So he is telling you that not only in Rajju, but wherever you see Sarpa, that Sarpa is completely non-existent, but you see it there as well. So what is the big deal in seeing it in Rajju? In Rajju also you will see, because elsewhere also you see, there is a Pratiti. It is Pratiti Matra. There is no Satta to this Sarpa anywhere. Imam eva asatkhyatim ahuhu shunyavadina. That vada is called as asat khyati vada by shunyavadis. Atyanta asata. Now it is explained what is this asat khyati. Atyanta asata. Asat is sitting in the shabda asat khyati. Atyanta asat. It is asat is atyanta asat. Atyanta asataha kasya asataha sarpasya khyati. So asataha khyati asat khyati. That is samasa vigraha. And what is asataha? Whatever you see. Pratiti matrasya sarpasya Rajju Sarpo. In Rajju Sarpa, Asataha Sarpasya Khyati. What is Khyati now? Khyati is Puranam. The appearance of Jnana of Pratiti of Asat Padartha Abhivadanam Cha Asat Khyatir Iti Aha. So Spuranam Abhivadanam. Nama Rupa. So Rupa Spuranam. And Abhivadana is Nama. So Nama, Rupa, both are Asat. And those which are Asat, their Khyati, meaning manifestation in what isn't there, has a name and form. That Khyati is called as Asat Khyati. Further, the Vijnanavadis disagrees with this view, Shunyavadi's view. They say what is not there at all cannot have an appearance. Atma khyatihi. Meaning, see why? Because here in their case, see what is the difference between asat khyati? This may appear similar to what has gone by. In Drishti Srishti Vada, Guru has said in Atma kalatre api samsaraha nasti. How is that any different than this Sarpa not being there anywhere? Here they are talking about Vyavaharika Satta. In Vyavaharika Satta also it isn't there. In Vedanta, in Vyavaharika Satta, there is Mithya Sarpa. There is Mithya Samsara. In Paramarthika alone, there is no Samsara. So in Vyavaharika Drishti it is there. That is one difference. Second difference, main difference, is that these Asat Khyati Vadis, Bauddhas, Shunya Vadis, they say even Atma is non-existent, which is a huge difference. We don't care about Prapancha not being there as much as Atma not being there, because Brahma is there. This is Shruti. Shruti focuses towards moksha through revealing Brahma, which is you. And then in that case, how can one say that Brahma isn't there? So Asat Khyati is nowhere close to Vedanta at all. There is a huge difference. Similarly with Atma Khyati of Vijnanavadis, there also between Vedanta and Vijnanavadi also there is a huge difference, close but huge difference, because their consciousness is momentary. Vijnana, which is consciousness, Vijnana or Jnana, which is consciousness, even in Siddhanta, Vedantis, Vedanta Siddhanta, the difference is that it is momentary for Atma Khyati Vadinaha, for Vijnanavadis. But for Vedantis, it is Nitya. Never can there be a segmentation at all, let alone, momentary. It is always there. It is the only thing there and always there. Huge difference again. Okay, Atma Khyati. Atma Khyati, Vijnanavadinaha Avipraayahatu. Rajyau va anyatra va buddhehe bahi kutrachiddapi na sarpoasti. So they also say sarpa is not there, whether it is in Rajju or elsewhere. Buddhehe bahi. If you say that outside your buddhi there is some sarpa, whether in Rajju or in Valmiki, then in Valmika or in Rajju. So here what we saw, Rajju, in Rajju or in Valmika, whether in Rajju or in Valmika Adav, there is Sarpa. Valmika or Adav, anywhere, no, wherever you see Sarpa, there also there is no Sarpa. Really it is not there, meaning Buddher Bahi Nasti means what? Buddha Vasti. It is in Buddhi, meaning it is Kalpita in Buddhi. Evam Sakala Padartha Api Na Buddher Bahir Vartante. So that Rajju Sarpa elsewhere, meaning Rajju also, the Prapancha, entire Prapancha, is what? Sakala Padartha Api Na Buddher Bahihi Vartante. They are Antarvarti Naha. Padarthaha, all padarthas are in the mind. Buddhereva sakala padarthanam akaran dhatte. So buddhi eva sakala padartha, buddhir eva sakala padarthanam akaran dhatte. Buddhi itself takes the form of all padarthas. Vritti rupa. And there is nothing outside. This may seem very close to Drishti Srishti Vada, but still they say that the buddhi which is undergoing change is Atma. Jnana, Vijnana, that buddhi is Vijnana, which Sacha buddhi hi Kshanika Vijnana Rupa. It is momentary. Vritti is momentary. We also say Vritti is momentary. Okay, Sakala Padarthanam Akarandhatte. We also say it is true. Vritti takes the form of Ghatapatadi, Jagadakara Vritti, Atmakara, Anatmakara Vritti, Ghatakara, Patakara Vritti. All these is there in Siddhanta also. But Sacha Buddhi Kshanika Vijnana Rupa, we do not agree. Sacha Buddhi Kshanika Vijnana. Vijnana is Chaitanya. Chaitanya Rupa it isn't. It appears to be Chaitanya Rupa, but that Buddhi, Vritti is Kshanika, all right, but it is not Kshanika Vijnana, Kshanika Chaitanya. They say it is Kshanika Chaitanya. Vijnana is Chaitanya. Pratikshanam Utpatti Vinasha Shali Yad Vijnanam Tadeva Sarpatmana Vabhasate. Each and every moment the buddhi which is changing, Vijnana which is changing, it is Utpatti Vinasha Shali. Comes up and goes. Their examples are like the flow of water. If the river is flowing, if you dip your hand in water, the water that you feel now, and then you take your hand away and you put it back in water, in the flowing water, in the river, the second time you put your hand, it feels like the same water, it appears like the same water. There is a pratiti of same jala being there. However, the jala that you have touched is different from the earlier jala you touched. Or another example is a flame. The lamp that is burning, it appears like a single unit of fire, single flame of fire. But still, the fuel that is burnt is giving rise to another flame. Every moment there is a different flame. And the appearance of the continuous flame is a bhranti. ఇట్ ఇస్ అ క్షణిక విజ్ఞాన. ఎంటైర్ ప్రపంచ ఇస్ లైక్ దట్. ది వృత్తి ఆఫ్ ది మైండ్ ఇస్ క్షణిక, బుద్ధి వృత్తి ఇస్ క్షణిక, అండ్ దట్ ఇస్ విజ్ఞాన విచ్ ఇస్ క్షణిక, విచ్ ఇస్ చైతన్య, దట్ ఇస్ క్షణిక. ప్రతిక్షణం ఉత్పత్తి వినాశశాలి యద్ విజ్ఞానం, ఇట్ ఇస్ చైతన్యం దేర్, తదేవ సర్పాత్మన ఉపాసే, దాట్ ఇట్ సెల్ఫ్ అపియర్స్ యాజ్ సర్ప. వై సర్ప? ఇట్ అపియర్స్ యాజ్ రజ్జు ఆల్సో. వై రజ్జు? ఇట్ అపియర్స్ యాజ్ ఎంటైర్ ప్రపంచ. ఇయం ఆత్మఖ్యాతిర్ ఇతి వర్ణ్యతే. దిస్ ఇట్ సెల్ఫ్ ఇస్ కాల్డ్ యాజ్ ఆత్మఖ్యాతి. ఆత్మ ఇస్ వాట్ దేర్ క్షణిక విజ్ఞాన రూప బుద్ధి చైతన్య, దట్ ఇస్ ఆత్మ విచ్ ఇస్ క్షణిక విజ్ఞాన రూప. దిస్ ఇస్ అ హ్యూజ్ డిఫరెన్స్. క్షణిక మొమెంటరీ. వీ డు నాట్ హ్యావ్ ఎనీథింగ్ ఇన్ ది డెఫినేషన్ ఆఫ్ ఆత్మ విచ్ ఇస్ మొమెంటరీ. ఇట్ ఇస్ ఆల్ నిత్య. సత్యం జ్ఞానం అనంతం. సత్య వర్డ్ ఇట్ సెల్ఫ్ ఇస్ నిత్య. ద ఫస్ట్ వెరీ ఫస్ట్ వర్డ్ టెల్స్ యు దట్ ఇట్ కెనాట్ బి మొమెంటరీ ఎవర్. ఈవెన్ ఇన్ సుషుప్తి, even in death we say chaitanya does not ever go alupta druk. That chaitanya nasato vidyate bhavah na bhavo vidyate satah satah abhavo na vidyate. That is the siddhanta. It can nowhere be close to kshanika vijnana. Those who compare this, as I was saying yesterday, neither do they know Buddhism nor Vedanta. We can safely conclude it. However big the person is, if the person says that Vedanta, any description of Vedanta, be it Drishti Srishti Vada, even if we say that Prapancha is never there, complete Atyantam Asat, Parmarthika Drishtya, even if we make that statement, which is a statement made by Shruti, we cannot be compared to Kshanika Vijnana. Close, in Jagat interpretation, close, but then Chaitanya cannot be discounted as అనిత్య ఆర్ క్షణిక. తస్యాః ఖ్యాతిః స్ఫురణం అభివదనం చ ఆత్మఖ్యాతిరితి. ది ఫార్మ్ అండ్ నేమ్ ఆల్ దట్ ఇస్ ఖ్యాతి. స్ఫురణం అండ్ అభివదనం ఇస్ వాట్ బుద్ధి. సో తస్య బుద్ధి బుద్ధే ఖ్యాతి. ఆత్మఖ్యాతి ఇస్ ఆత్మ ఇస్ బుద్ధి. సో ఆత్మనా ఖ్యాతి ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు బుద్ధే ఖ్యాతి చైతన్య ఖ్యాతి. అండ్ ఖ్యాతి ఇస్ లైక్ ఎర్లియర్ స్ఫురణం అండ్ అభివదనం. So that is Atmakhyati. The next is Anyatakhyati. Anyatakhyati of Sankhyas and Prabhakaravata. Anyatha is in another way. So it seems very, very close to Siddhanta. Because Anyatha, but Anyatha also has a loaded meaning. Khyati also has a loaded meaning. తత్ర నైయాయిక వైశేషికాణం. సారీ, దిస్ ఇస్ అన్యతాఖ్యాతి. ఐ మీన్ అఖ్యాతి. సో అఖ్యాతి ఇస్ గోయింగ్ టు కమ్ అప్ నెక్స్ట్ ఇయర్. అన్యతాఖ్యాతి, అన్యతాఖ్యాతి ఇస్ అపియరింగ్ డిఫరెంట్లీ, బట్ దెన్ అగైన్ అన్యథ ఆల్సో మీన్స్ డిఫరెంట్ దెన్ వాట్ ఇట్ ఇస్, విచ్ ఇస్ వాట్ లిటరలీ ఇట్ వుడ్ మీన్. బట్ దెన్ విల్ సీ వాట్ దే ఇంటర్ప్రిటెడ్. వి సే అన్యథ యాజ్ ఇన్ వాట్ ఈస్ దేర్ అపియర్స్ డిఫరెంట్లీ, బట్ దెన్ వీ డోంట్ కాల్ ఇట్ యాజ్ అన్యతాఖ్యాతి. అవర్ ఖ్యాతి ఇస్ డిఫరెంట్. విల్ కమ్ టు దాట్. అనిర్వచనీయ ఖ్యాతి. ఎవర్ ఖ్యాతి? అనిర్వచనీయ ఖ్యాతి. సిద్ధాంత తత్ర నైయాయిక వైశేషికాణ మతం. వాట్ డు ది లాజిషియన్స్ సే? వల్మీకాదౌ పారమార్థిక సర్పో అస్తి. దే డు నాట్ ఈవెన్ కన్సిడర్ దిస్ సర్ప యాజ్ భ్రమ. రియలీ భ్రమ యాజ్ ఎ నాన్ ఎగ్జిస్టెంట్ సర్ప. దే డోంట్ సే ఇట్ ఇస్ అ నాన్ ఎగ్జిస్టెంట్ సర్ప. ద్వైతిన్స్ ఆల్సో టాక్ ఇన్ ది సేమ్ మేనర్. ద్వైతిన్స్ ఆర్ దేర్ ఫోర్ ఎల్స్వేర్. ఐ థింక్ సమ్ స్కాలర్, some modern scholar, perhaps Dasgupta, he says that Dvaitins are prachanna nayayikaha. They are hidden logicians, which makes sense. They are hidden logicians. Their conclusions are similar to logicians without having basis in Shruti, because they are very picky. They pick the Shruti statement to fit their conclusion. They don't have a broad overview. They don't take the entire Shastra into consideration. They have contradictions all the way. Not only contradictions, whenever there are contradictions, what do? If we have contradiction, we have a hierarchy. Shruti, Smriti, Purana, Itihasa, Ityadi, all are Pramanas as long as they do not contradict this Shruti, because they are derivatives of Shruti. So whenever there is a contradiction or apparent contradiction between the Shruti statement and a Smriti or a lower Pramana, then we reinterpret the lower Pramana to fit the Shruti. We do not modify the Shruti. If there is an apparent contradiction between two Shruti statements, we reinterpret the meaning, not adding words. We reinterpret the meaning in context to fit the context in such a manner that there is never a contradiction with any other Shruti statement. And how do we do that? How do we decide whether the first statement should be reinterpreted or the second? This is in keeping with Tatpari of the Shruti, which we conclude not according to our whims or logic, dry logic, Shushka Tarka. It is as per Shadlinga. Tatpari Nishchaya is made through Shadlingas, and those Shadlingas are analysis of the entire Shastra. Each and every Upanishad has the same conclusion. Therefore, whichever is in line with that conclusion, that Shruti statement will hold on to. The other will be reinterpreted based on the context. This is our process. Their process is they have concluded and they'll pick Shruti statements to quote only those. Others they'll wish away or they'll add words to the Shruti. They add words. Tattvamasi will be Atattvamasi. There they'll do a different Padachheda. Then here anyway, with Eng of Padanta Rati, Shweta Keto Tattvamasi, there is a possibility of Padachheda as Atattvamasi. Possible. But then they also explain Tattvam Asi as Tattvam as a compound. And then they say Tasyattvamasi, Tenattvamasi, Tasmintvamasi, all these kind of compounding expressions are given. The Vigraha Vakyas of the compound are explained. But how Tattvam and Asi? Tattvam is neuter and Shweta Ketu is being told you are Tattvam, makes no sense at all. However, they do explain in any which way to fit their conclusion. Here at least it is possible, but elsewhere they'll even break the grammatical rules which are not even applicable at all. There are no such rules possible. They'll bring in some additional meaning, buddhi kalpita, to some word, and they'll split the word in middle of the word itself. They'll split it. There is no rule for kridanta or taddita there. They just split it and give explanation for each part and get away with that. Otherwise, they'll add words to the Shruti. Very asadhu way. Why? Because there is no blessing of the Shruti. Because there is no respect towards the Shruti. There is a pre-conclusion. This is what Dvaitis also do. They base it on Nyaya, Tarka. Hidden, their conclusions are similar to Tarka. If you see, these Nayayikas' conclusions and Dvaitis' conclusions are similar because Nayayikas are also Dvaitins. Everyone other than Advaitin is a Dvaitin. Even Shunyavadi is a Dvaiti. How? By not being an Advaiti. One who is not an Advaiti, iti Dvaiti. Tatra Nayayika Vaisheshikana Matam. What is their matam? Valmikadav Parmarthika Sarpa Asti. The Sarpa is real. Dvaitin say Swapna. If you give them Swapna example, they say Swapna is real. You cannot argue with such people. It is not possible. That's why Bhagavan Karikakara, he establishes how Swapna Prapancha is Mithya. First, to use it as an example, because the Dvaitin is, there is no Dvaitin the way we have Dvaitins here. There is no Dvaita Vedanta. Actually, Dvaita Vedanta is a misnomer. There is no Vedanta which is Dvaita. Anything that is non-Advaita Vedanta cannot be categorized as Vedanta at all because their basis is Purana. They bring in Vayu Purana, Padma Purana, Bhagavatam to justify their expressions of Upanishad. Very ridiculous. There is no Shruti as Pramana at all. Bhagavatam is a Paurushiya Grantha becomes a Pramana. Padma Purana is a Pramana, for God's sake. I mean, and then they say they are Bhaktas. How can you bhakta and, you know, discard Ishvara Vachana, which is Shruti, and take to some Paurusheya Grantha, giving up Apaurusheya Ishvara Krita? Not even Ishvara Krita, but let's take it that way. Ishvara's Prana is Shruti. You give that away and you take some Paurusheya Grantha, interpret. There also you be picky. We have seen Bhagavata quotations yesterday where there also Advaita is pervading through the Grantha. There is an underlying current of Advaita which is said in so many words literally, by Bhagavan Vyasa also, still they'll be picky and they'll use that to reinterpret Shruti. Thereby, Swapna itself is real. Swapna is real for them. And Bhagavan Karikakara refutes the possibility of Swapna being real by giving, you know, Uchita Desha Kala lacking. That is how the analysis goes. And same thing extended to Prapancha. Swapnavat Jagradapi Mithya. That is the logic used in Vaithatya Prakarana in Mandukya Karika. Similarly, like Swapna is real for them, Paramarthika, Atyanta real. They do not have this Vyavahareka Satta. They only have Paramarthika Satta and they have Pratibhasika Satta. In Pratibhasika Satta also, some places they won't accept that it is Pratibhasika even. Appears alright, but it is real elsewhere. So this Rajju Sarpa example, they take in a very different manner. The Sarpa that you see is not Pratibhasika Sarpa, it is Paramarthika Sarpa. They say it is a really existent Sarpa. Even in the case of Rajju Sarpa, how do they say Valmikadau? First, that Sarpa which is there is Valmik in Valmika. The Sarpa which is there in Sarpa Bila, that is Paramarthika Sarpa. So it is really existent Sarpa. Vyavahitopi sa sarpas chakshusha grihyate. Now this Sarpa which is there in Valmika, they say the Sarpa that you see in front of you is Bhranti, but that Sarpa is real. Your seeing Sarpa in front of you is Bhranti. Not that the Sarpa is non-existent, that Sarpa is there somewhere else. You see that Sarpa here now, that is Bhranti. So Valmikadav Paramarthika Sarpa, Yaha Sarpa Paramarthika Sarpa Valmikadav Asti, Sa Eva Atra Pratibhasate, Atra Bhasate, Rajyav. So that Sarpa is seen here. Imagine, this is Nayayika. They call themselves as logicians and they say that logic, look at the logic. Of course, this is logic, it is not science. Somewhere else there is Sarpa, that Sarpa is seen here now in Rajju. Vyavahitopi, even if it is far placed, somewhere else it is. Vyavahitopi sa sarpas chakshusha grihyate. And how is it seen here? You know, your eyes see. Your eyes are seeing the Sarpa in the Sarpa Bila, and that Sarpa, your eyes see here. Chakshir gata dosha bala. Why? How is that possible? There is dosha in your eyes. What kind of dosha? The dosha that makes you see Sarpa elsewhere as here. Your eyes are seeing the Bilagata Sarpa, which is seen here. How can that be? Dosha. Imagine if you have a defect, in a defect you see less. If somebody has cataract or glaucoma or, you know, some kind of a squinted eye or something, some defect in the eye, can that person see something at a distance? He'll not be able to see something which is nearby even, which others can see. But they say due to this defect, you are able to see something which is far placed. Vyavahita api sarpa chakshusha. What kind of chakshusha? Chakshur gata dosha. Balat chakshusha grihyate. So chakshur gata dosha balat vyavahita sarpa. Look at this. Dosha has a bala. Contradictory. Dosha and bala are contradictory. How can there be bala in dosha? The dosha itself can be stronger. So there can be a defect which is stronger, as in more defect, intense dosha. But they are saying due to the strength, there is a strength of dosha. Defect has a strength which makes you see things at a distance. That is a siddhi really. It would be a siddhi. How can siddhi be called as a dosha? Chakshurgata dosha balat vyavahita sarpa api puratas chakshushas sannikrishto bhati. Appears to be here, very near, connected to the eye, here and now, in the Rajju, whereas it is there elsewhere, but your eyes are seeing the real sarpa. Paramarthika sarpas chakshushascha madhye kudyadi rupa vyavadhana sattve api dosas sachiva chakshusha vyavahita sarpo api grihyate eva. And their argument is that Parmarthika Sarpa, which is there, that Sarpa, Chakshusha, between the Parmarthika Sarpa, where in Valmika and Chakshu, between Chakshu, Madhye, Tayoho Madhye, between them, there is a lot of things. Kudyadi Rupa Vyavadhana Satvi. There are a lot of things which are there, Padarthas in between. Still, you are able to see only the Parmarthika Sarpa elsewhere, missing everything in between. You don't see anything in between. And you see some Sarpa somewhere in Valmika. That is due to Dosha. Dosha Sachiva Chakshusha. Because the Chakshu has Dosha. Due to that, Vyavahita Sarpa Api Grihyate Eva. Further, there is an objection to this. How can that be possible? Nanu dosha samavadhanena vastuna samarthyahani reva drishyate na vriddhi. With a defect, you always have weakening. If the sense organ has a defect, they weaken. They do not become strong. So, samarthyahani eva drishyate. The capacity to see should have reduced. But here you are talking about vriddhi. Vriddhi na drishyate. How can there be something which is not seen to another normal eye? Due to defect one sees, how is that possible? Yatha vata pitta kaphadi doshaihi jatharagnehe ashita pitta pachana shakti kuntitha bhavati tatha timiradi doshaihi chakshushaha shaktirapi kuntitayo bhavet. So this is an objection to the Nayayikas, Vaisheshikas and Nayayikas. This is not a Siddhanta being questioned. Their Siddhanta is being questioned. So this is a Puro Paksha to Nayayika, meaning to Anyatha Khyati Vadinaha. To them, we ask, how is it that, we as in someone, some Puro Pakshi asks, how is it that due to dosha in the chakshu, you can see something more than a normal eye. Example given is vata, pitta, kapha. These are the three defects, sharira gata. In sharira, Ayurveda says, oh, vata is more, pitta is more, kapha is more. These are doshas. If there is imbalance and one becomes more, then it is a dosha. And due to those doshas, Jatharagnehe Ashita Pita Pachana Shaktihi Kuntita Bhavati. The Pachana Shakti, Pita Shakti, the Ashita Pita Pachana Shakti. What is eaten, the Jatharagni Shakti is Kuntita. What is that Shakti useful for? For Pachana Kriya to digest. The capacity of the Jatharagni to digest what is eaten and drunk, that becomes less. Tatha timiradi doshaihi chakshusha shaktirapi kuntitayo bhave. And if there is a defect in the eye, which you are pointing out in this Rajju Sarpa Drishtanta, the chakshugata dosha will reduce the shakti of the chakshu to see. It will not increase it. Kincha yadi valmikastha sarpo dosha sahita chakshusha grihyate tarihi shuddhanetrena vyavahita vastu pratyakshan na bhavati. Further, what is the issue with your explanation? If the sarpa which is there in Valmika, that is seen through an eye which has defect, then that sarpa should be seen only by the dosha sahita chakshu, only if there is a defect. Because you have already made a statement that sarpa which is in Valmika is seen because of the Chakshu Dosha. Now, Chakshur Dosha makes you see Sarpa in Valmika, then Shuddha Netrina, that Netra Chakshu which does not have defect, that should not see anything Vivahita Vastu Pratyakshan Na Bhavati. A regular eye should not and cannot see whatever the Sarpa in Valmika. Kintu dushta netrena eva iti vaktavyam. Then you should say what? The Valmikastha sarpa can be seen only by dushta netra, not by shuddha netra. There is a tippana here. Vaktavya means you should say. And if you say that, it's an issue. Why? Vyavahitam vastu shuddha netrena na upalabhyate. किंतु दुष्टनेत्रेण उपलभ्यते इति उक्ति ही लोक विरुद्धा. इफ यू से दैट सम समथिंग एट अ डिस्टेंस इज सीन ओनली बाय अ डिफेक्टिव आई नॉट बाय नॉर्मल आई इट इज रॉन्ग. वॉट इज एट अ डिस्टेंस कैन बी सीन बाय अ नॉर्मल आई और कैनॉट बी सीन बाय नॉर्मल आई बट इट कैन नेवर बी सीन बाय डिफेक्टिव आई इट इज लोक विरुद्धा. हाउ कैन यू यूज दैट For Anumana, you call yourselves as logicians. Logic should be, Anumana should be based on Pratyaksha. What is your Pratyaksha Pramana here? Loka Gata Pratyaksha, nothing is there. It is Loka Pratyaksha Viruddha. What kind of logician are you? So this is the question there. Tasma dosha sahita chakshusha samarthyam vardhata ityatra drishtanto nasti iti chet. There is no example to prove that दोष युक्त इंद्रिय और दोष युक्त एनीथिंग कैन इंक्रीज इट्स कैपेसिटी सामर्थ्यम वर्धते. देयर इज नो नो एग्जांपल. सो द लॉजिशियन सेज आई हैव थॉट अबाउट ऑल दिस. व्हाट डू यू थिंक दैट आई एम अ लॉजिशियन फॉर फॉर यू आई मे नॉट बी बट आई एम अ लॉजिशियन. आई विल शो यू द लॉजिक दैट आई यूज. आई विल गिव एन एग्जांपल वेयर सामर्थ्य इंक्रीजेस ड्यू टू दोष. ही टेक्स द questioner's example and says nayam doshaha. This is not an issue at all. Drishtanta sadbhava. There is a drishtanta. Where have you seen? I'll show you where I have seen. You have also seen. Tathahi pittadikya prayukta bhasmaka rogabhi bhutasya kasyachit chaturgunitam api annam shudam shamayitum nalam bhavati. So there is a particular dosha, bhasmaka roga, which is due to pitta increasing. So if the pitta increases, then the hunger increases. So pitta adikya prayukta bhasmaka roga vibhutasya kasyachit chatur gunitam api annam. So particular guna should be there in anna. You know, there are some gunas in anna. All gunas are there in anna, but still kshudam shamayitum nalam bhavati. Cannot It cannot fill the hunger. It cannot take away hunger. The hunger continues to be there. So, it has increased hunger. Pitta increases hunger. He is not talking about digestive system at all. He says, Pitta increases hunger. That is the example. Pitta is a dosha. If the dosha is there, then hunger increases. Vardhate eva. I mean, with this, one can even argue, you know, this is what Shushka Tarka is. Our example is what? We have questioned with the example. The questioner, what is he asking? In the example, he says the dosha is increasing, the shakti. What is the shakti of the Jataragni? It is to digest. That is becoming rest. But this fellow is saying that hunger increases. Hunger is a disease. In Ayurveda Shastra also, Shutpipasa is roga. That roga will increase when pitta increases. What is an example? This is not an example really. If the dosha increases, roga increases, that is not samarthya increasing. This is what Shushka Tarka is. You can give any example. You can give any example and prove through any logic. Anything can be proven. That's why we want the conclusion to be in line with Shruti. Any tarka which is divorced from Shruti, there may be a hetvabhasa. There is a hetu given, but it is an abhasa that hetu doesn't work. Anyway, he has given an example. Tatra pitta doshane yatha jatragane he pachana shakti vardhate. He says pachana shakti has increased. Why? Because how much ever you eat, the hunger remains. That hunger is a disease, but he takes the pachana shakti to have increased. How much ever he eats, he is still hungry. Tatha chakshushopi doshair vyavahita sarpadi pratyakshi karana shaktir vardhata iti vaktum yuktam. Therefore, using this example, I can expand it to the exemplified, extend it and say, similarly, when chakshu has doshas, then the vyavahita sarpa can also be pratyaksha right in front of me because it increases the pratyakshikarana shakti. The chakshugata dosha has increased my shakti to see at a distance. It has given me a siddhi. Everyone will crave for this kind of a dosha if they can see something at a distance. इत्थंच वल्मीकादि प्रदेशांतरे स्थित सर्पस्य अन्यथा ख्याति वल्मीकादि प्रदेशांतरे अन्य प्रदेशे इन अ डिफरेंट प्रदेश स्थित सर्पस्य दैट सर्प विच इज प्रेजेंट इन अ डिफरेंट प्लेस व्यवहित अन्यथा ख्याति अन्यथा इज प्रकारांतरेण व्हाट इज प्रकारांतरेण देयर इज अ रीजन व्हाई ही सेज प्रकारांतरेण ही इज गोइंग टू रीयूज लेटर अन्यथा इज प्रकारांतरेण इज पुरः अवस्थित रज्जु प्रदेशे रज्जुदेशे ख्याति ही स्फुरणम अभिवदनं च अन्यथा ख्याति इति कथ्यते सो ख्याति मीनिंग इज सेम स्फुरणम एंड अभिवदनम नाम रूप of what this prakarantaran anyatha anyatha is what prakar in another way another manner in which manner it is elsewhere pradeshantara but in pradeshantare what is there puraha purovastita rajju deshe khyati appearance in name and form of that which is elsewhere in a different manner means what should be seen at a distance is seen here in rajju right in front of me that itself is anyata khyatihi kathyate now the difference is this these nayayikas are old nayayikas old school of logic there is navya nyaya was rewritten completely rewritten by a great logician but why was it rewritten because भगवान भाष्यकार हैज कंप्लीटली बैश्ड अप द न्याय स्कूल ऑफ थॉट इट वाज कंप्लीटली रिफ्यूटेड बिकॉज ऑफ ऑल दिस यू नो बेसिक नॉनसेंस इफ यू लुक एट इट सो इट वाज रीरिटन एंड देयर डेफिनेशंस हैव बीन मेड सो कॉम्प्लिकेटेड नव्य न्याय इज सो कॉम्प्लिकेटेड फॉर अ डेफिनेशन देयर इज अ कंपाउंड्स व्हिच आर यू नो रन इनटू मल्टीपल लाइंस फॉर अ सिंगल वर्ड multiple line compounds because they want it to be perfect in their thought their logic should be perfect thereby they used they rewrote their nyaya that is called navya nyaya and navya nyaya disagree with this khyati also we'll see that in the next part as to what is their disagreement with this anyata khyati that is also prakarantarina but what is that prakarantarina we'll see in the next part I will stop here and we'll continue with khyati sukam nityam saprakasham vyapakam namarupayo adhishtanam buddhi buddhyam buddheer dakyattu nirmanam param sarvedanta vidyam pratyak paramah tadeva hanumatto iti me nishchitamatihi any questions No questions. I'll see you in the next part. Namaste.
Namaste. Hari Om.